to my class. You know that I'm Ali Munisa, teacher and junior lecturer of Elizabeth High School and Junior College. So in previous class already we have discussed. Now after the poverty in India, we will discuss about the unemployment in India with concept, types, causes, consequences and remedial measures. The size of employment in a country depend to a great extent on the level of development. Exactly. When a country makes progress and its production expands, the employment opportunities grow automatically, of course. So here in India, during the past 3 decades, here the production has expanded in all the sectors of the economy. So this has happened because during the first 3 decades of the economic planning and trade rate growth was considerably lower than the target rate. Okay. So here the jobs in adequate number were not created, but here the economic growth by itself does not solve the problems of unemployment. Exactly. So in a broad sense, the state of unemployment appears when a laborer does not obtain the employment opportunity despite his willingness to work on existing wage rate. Obviously. So here in India is a developing economy where the nature of unemployment is entirely different from that of the developed nations. Exactly. Here the Lord J.M. Keynes diagnosed the unemployment in a developed economy to be the real result of a deficiency in the effective demand. According to the Keynes here, the such unemployment can be removed from the economy by increasing the effective demand. Exactly. But in developing economies like India, the unemployment situation arises due to different reasons. Exactly. Here these economies also face the problems of inflation side by side with the problems of unemployment also. Exactly. So after this, now we will see the types of unemployment. So here in types of unemployment, there are different types of unemployment like structural unemployment and the underemployment and the distinguished unemployment and open unemployment and educated unemployment and the frictional unemployment and the seasonal unemployment and technological unemployment. Here all these are the different types of unemployment. Now we will see the concept of unemployment. Here the concept of unemployment. In this concept, a person working for 8 hours a day for 273 days of a year is regarded as a employed on a standard person year, that is SPY basis. Okay. Here on the basis of the recommendations of the committee of experts on unemployment estimates set up by the planning commission, there are 3 estimates of the unemployment were generated in the 27th round of NSS. Okay. So, and that are chronic unemployment or usual principal status unemployment. And second one is that the weekly status unemployment. And third one is that the daily status unemployment. Okay. All these are the concepts of unemployment. So after the concepts of unemployment, now we will see the causes of unemployment. Some of the main causes of unemployment are here. They are jobless growth, increase in labor force and inappropriate technology and inappropriate educational system and neoliberal economic policy. All these are the causes of unemployment. Now we will see the consequences of unemployment. So here the consequences of unemployment. Here the widespread unemployment in urban as well as in rural India is a complex problem caused by the many factors. Exactly. So here the unemployment affects not just the person himself but also his or her family. Exactly. And in the long run the society where the person lives, obviously. Here the unemployment brings with it despair, unhappiness and anguish. So here the major consequences of the problem of unemployment are as loss of human resources, increase in poverty, social problems and the political instability and the exploitation of labor and standard of livings and employment gaps and loss of skills usage. All these are the consequences of unemployment here. So after these consequences of unemployment, now we will see the remedial measures for this. Okay. So here the remedial measures. Unemployment was recognized as a problem from the very beginning of the planning process in India. So here it, despite the removal of unemployment, has been proclaimed objective of Indian economic planning. Until the sixth plan, one does not find any references to long-term employment policy with a bold approach of tackle. Here, the unemployment approach to tackle the unemployment problem in the country. So, accordingly, here the employment generation was accepted as a goal of development planning. Okay. After this, faster growth with the special emphasis on employment intensive sectors, like growth with the special emphasis of the employment intensive sectors like the small scale industries, was considered adequate to generate the employment of the order required to take care of the problems. Okay. So the following the publication of the Bhagwati Committee report in 1973, here the government took the following measures to provide the employment and alleviate the underemployment, and they are as the rural work program and the marginal farmers and agriculture labor agency and small farmers development agencies and integrated dry land agriculture development and agro services centers and area development schemes and crash program for the rural employment and the employment guarantee scheme of Maharashtra, that is EGS, and the National Rural Employment Program, that is NREP, and the Rural Landless Employment Guarantee Program, that is RLEGP, and IRDP, that is Integrated Rural Development Program, and the Rural Employment Program, that is REP. Okay, and the Jawahar Rozgar Yojana and the Indira Awas Yojana, that is IAY. Okay. And the Jawahar Gram Samriddhi Yojana, that is JGSY. And Swarna Jayanti Gram Swara Rozgar Yojana, that is SGSY. Okay. And at last, the Swarna Jayanti Sahari Rozgar Yojana, that is SJSRY. All these are the remedial measures. Okay. Now we will see the poverty alleviation and employment generation program in India. So here, after the remedial measures, poverty alleviation and employment generation programs in India. In this, first we will go with the earlier phase with ad hoc approach. So here the strategy of direct assault on the poverty through the rural development and the rural employment programs was first adopted in 1970s with the fifth plan. Here the poverty alleviation come to be accepted as one of the principal objectives of economic planning in India. Exactly. So during 1970s, a number of special programs for the rural poor were undertaken, of which is the important ones were the Small Farmers Development Agency, that is SFDA, and the Marginal Farmers and Agricultural Laborers Development Agency, that is MFAL, and Drought Prone Areas Program, that is DPAP, and the Krish Scheme for Rural Employment, that is CSRE. Okay, and the Pilot Intensive Rural Employment Project, that is PIREP, and the Food for the Work Programs, that is FWP. None of these programs comprehensively covered the whole country. In certain parts of the country, some of these programs operated simultaneously for the same target groups. So apart from these territorial overlap, the major limitation of these programs was that they were reduced to merely subsidy giving programs. So here the lacking and the planned approach to enable the rural poor to achieve a higher level of income. So here the element of ad hocism is these programs further reduce their effectiveness from the point of view of poverty alleviation. Get it? So here the need was felt to undertaking the programs which were not only for more comprehensive in coverage but could also make a direct assault on the rural poverty. Get it? So after this first phase, now we will see and discuss about the latter phase, that is comprehensive programs. Here the latter phase with the comprehensive programs, in this the Integrated Rural Development Program, that is IRDP, and the National Rural Employment Program, that is NREP, and the Rural Landless Employment Guarantee Program, that is RLEGP, were conceived keeping the objective of a poverty alleviation in the view. Here the IRDP was initially started in 1978 to 1979. In this, 2300 development blocks as a program of total development. So in the sixth plan, that the IRDP was extended to the entire country, and the NREP also commenced at the same time as a part of sixth plan and aimed at helping the segment of the population which depend largely on the wage employment and had virtually no source of income during the lean agricultural period. So here the RLEGP was launched on August 15 in 1983. Here, with the objectives of the expanding the employment opportunities for the rural landless. Okay, so with the view to making the implementation of these wage employment programs were more effective, here the NREP and RLEGP were merged into a single rural employment program since April 1st in 1989. So here this merged program was named after Jawaharlal Nehru as Jawahar Rozgar Yojana, that is JRY. Get it? So after these two phases, now we will discuss about the strategy of poverty alleviation and employment generation programs. So in this, here a careful examination of the poverty alleviation programs reveals that the planners have made the assumptions that the poor constitute a homogeneous category, and that the planners made number of attempts to segment the group in terms of common strength, in terms of common characteristics and their requirements. So at present, this seems to be a title integration in transfer of assets and skill approach and the employment approach. Get it? So it is suggested that in future there has to be a greater coordination between these two elements of poverty alleviation program, and the actual mix between these two will however depend on the circumstances and the prevailing in the particular region for which the micro level plan is prepared. Exactly. So here the major limitation of the existing poverty alleviation strategy is that it has a number of programs for those households who neither have assets nor skills, and in addition do not have any able-bodied adult members and cannot benefit from wage employment programs. So for such a category, separate the policy measures would be required, and obviously these disputes are to be covered under the social security schemes. Okay, social security schemes. So here the bird's eye view of a various poverty alleviation and employment generation programs in India taken up from time to time and has presented in this table. See this one. By this observation of table, we have covered and discussed and understand by this chapter that already we have discussed about the national income and the national per capita income and the sectoral contribution and share of public and private to the national income. Okay, and the inequalities in distribution of wealth and income, and the causes, concepts and consequences, and the types and the remedial measures of poverty, and as well as the employment. Okay, and as well as the employment in India. And at last, And at last, the poverty alleviation and the employment generation program in India. All these we have discussed in this chapter. So by this we have completed our chapter 3, that is national income, poverty and employment. Okay, thank you.